is the story of my life. Except these are all from memory and interviews and not an entirely objective take. As Irving Goffman says, you present a different, unique self depending on every situation. And I'm not exactly like this in everyday life. This is a heightened version of me because it's theater. So of course, there's no music in this like this in real life. I don't break into song normally. The music happens in my head. And since I'm the one narrating my own life, you would think I'm an unreliable narrator because I'm too close to the subject, which is me. It's true, you have a point. But I assure you, this piece is as authentic as possible because the truth lies within the authenticity of the artist. As my photography professor told me. Intro song!
Ako'y bata pa, nagigising sa mga kanta ni Jolina. Naglalaro sa kama na tila bang walang problema sa mundo. Nung kindergarten, palaging neat and clean. Mga grado sa school, mataas din. Trained to be perfect, nice, not me. Na tila bang haki ng mundo. Heto ako magpapakatotoo. Maraming hinanaing gustong ikwento. Bisexual woman in the patriarchy. What could go wrong? Hindi mapakali. I'm gonna show you the most fucked up shit that happened in my life. So please stay a bit. Frantic artist, infinite internet. What could go wrong? I don't know where I fit. Oh, 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 oh. I was slut shamed at a very young age. Now I've got all this pent up female. The world's a stage, but it feels more like a cage. Hide your pain with a smile like Marcel Marceau. I've always wanted to move out of this town. Cause toxic family culture's bringing me down. Left me feeling confused, refused, abused. A lot of drama, that's why I'm in front of you. Heto ako magpapakatotoo. Maraming hinanaing gustong ikwento. Bisexual woman in the patriarchy. What could go wrong? Hindi mapakali. I'm gonna show you the most fucked up shit that happened in my life. So please stay a bit. A frantic artist, infinite internet. What could go wrong? I don't know where I fit. Oh, 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 depressed at nakakulong sa kwarto. I'd be awesome. Tigilan mo na yung negatibong pag-isip. Dahil pagkakamalan kang walang asa. Kung madali lang sana to itigil. noon ko pa sana'ng to ginawa. Siguro ay mas naging masaya. Hindi lang ako depressed at nakakulong sa kwarto. But I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome. I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome. I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome. I'm still awesome, I'm not weak unlike what daddy told me. Awesome, I am awesome, I am awesome. Despite the aggression, I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome. All the aggression, I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome. I'm still awesome, I'm still awesome, I'm still
robot. ginagawa mo? Wala nga. Alam mo, when you rub your... Dugo yan. Don't touch it or else it'll bleed. Naglaro tayo na, sabi ng high school teacher ko. Ako muna. Sabi ng Christian living teacher ko na kasalanan magsuot ng maiksi dahil kasalanan yon sa mata ng Diyos. You're provoking them to look at you. You're making them sin. Kaya huwag magsuot ng maiksi. Sabi niya. Kaya nga init-init dito sa Pinas. At huwag natin sinisisi yung biktima. Siya na nga yung biktima, oh. Siya pa may kasalanan. Ay yung batang natutulog kasama yung mama niya. Kinidnap at pinagsamantalahan bago pa man niya natutunang magsalita. Yung 13 taong gulang, estudyante, naka-uniforme, kasalanan pa rin niya yun? Hindi. Sisihin naman natin yung may pakanaang abusong ito. Boys will be boys. No. Boys will be held accountable for their actions. Oh, next. Ikaw naman. Sabi ng high school teacher ko... Sige. Ako naman ulit. Sabi ng high school teacher ko na bawal daw mag-crossdress o magdamit pang babae kapag ikay lalaki o magdamit pang lalaki kapag ikay babae. Phew! Red tight pants! Boots! And a woman's blouse. I would like to remind you that cross-dressing is not allowed. Sabi na sa harap ng buong klase. Yung classmate ko naman, tahimik lang. Walang masabi. Hindi ba nang sabihin? Ma'am, wala naman atang masama sa suot niya. Saka, paano ba natin nadedetermine na ito? Damit panlalaki? Ito, damit pambabae? I believe clothes have no gender. At alam mo ba, ma'am, pag pinigilan natin yung estudyante magsuot ng gusto nilang suotin o yung gender expression nila, it can negatively affect their self-esteem and academics. Mom, ayaw niyo namang gumagsak siya sa subjects niya, di ba? Oh, pagbigyan niyo na. May iba pang pwede pagtuunan ng pansin dito sa paaralan, katulad ng bullying, sexual harassment, toxic masculinity, and misogyny. Huwag na sana nating dagdagan pa ng gender discrimination at heteronormativity. Who here agrees with Miss Figura?
Thank you.
Big crazy.
crazy, a little bit crazy. I go a little bit crazy, no. You're the only guy that when I'm around with, I don't have to hide. You still love me no matter what I like. Yeah, you're my life. Am I the girl you'd want to marry and settle down with? Am I the girl you'd want to spend forever with? Oh, oh, I love you when you go. Oh, in the rain and dance with me. I go a little bit crazy, a little bit crazy. You are the best thing I've ever had. Even when you're mad, we're gonna make it go a little bit crazy, a little bit crazy. I go a little bit crazy, no. Oh, I know that it shows, but I want you to know. Love you and I don't wanna let you go. Oh, I hope you're here tonight. I'll tell you how I'd like to kiss you and hold you tight. Oh, oh, I love you when you go. Oh, in the rain and dance with me. I go a little bit crazy, a little bit crazy. Are the best thing I've ever had. Even when you're mad, we're gonna make it go a little bit crazy, a little bit crazy. I go a little bit crazy, no.
Hanggang ngayon, meron pa rin ganito with the rise of pick-me girls.
think about, castoid became a weapon for misogyny rather quickly. May mga babaeng tinatawag na pick me just because they identify as a nerd or vocally loves pizza or has close relationships with boys. These are their personalities and mannerisms that just make them who they are, even though they don't have internalized misogyny, pero ginagamit ng salitang pick me laban sa kanila, even though the very definition and essence of the term has been twisted to fit the narrative of the patriarchy. Mula pagkabata, gusto ko na talaga maging artista sa gawing balilit, mga teleserye at pelikula. Nakapasok ako sa teatro noong 6 na taong gulang ako. Lalo't, palagi na akong sumasali sa mga musicals at singing contest. Pero sa tuwing sinasabi ko yung pangarap ko sa pamilya ko, kamag artista? Ayaw namin yan para sa'yo. Hirap-hirap yan, hasa lang yan. Tsoko, ano future mo dyan? Paano kung magputulan ka ng paa, tapos di ka na magkakaroon ng trabaho? Mas mabuti pa, magkaroon ka ng profession, katulad ng pagiging doktor o businesswoman. Noong senior year ko sa high school, inisip ko kung ano kayang kukunin kong kurso sa kolehiyo. I was in love with musical theater and performance, pero yung kinuha ko BS accountancy. Ang lungkot-lungkot ko noon kasi araw-araw pinanood ko yung mga idol at inspirasyon ko sa teatro at sa pagkakanta. I said if I had a chance to pursue my dreams, I'd do everything. I'd give my best. I'd be willing to suffer. Kaya after some fights with my parents, nagsulat ako ng mahabang letter kung bakit ko kailangan mag-shift now na sa teatro. Ito, basahin mo. Minutes later. Ikaw na bahala! Paano ka maghanap ng school? Bahala ka na! Paano ka mag-apply dyan? Bahala ka na! And so, for the first time in forever, kinapalan ko yung mukha ko at inisikaso yung requirements at nag-audition sa UP Diliman! Makapasok naman ako. At doon ko nalaman lahat ng mga natutunan ko tungkol sa lipunan. Feminism, the LGBTQ+ community, and sexuality! Doon ko nasabing, I feel like I belong here more than I did back home. People understand. People care. Until some really bad shit happened. Some men just don't understand when women say no or are incapable of saying no. I've had girls sharing their stories with me. You'd be surprised how many women go through this. Your friend, your sister, your mother, it could be anyone. One of these stories was told to me by a friend who I will not name for obvious reasons, but it was a Christmas party in their organization.
Iinom ka ba?
Iinom ka?
Apa.
Sabi niya sa may-ari, ah, sige.
kwarto. Andun silang lahat sa kwarto, dun ka na lang. Sige. Papasok sa bahay. Can't think straight. Dead drunk. Paakyat. Wait lang. Pababa. Upo sa sala. Bridget ka pa ba? Sure ka? Anong gusto mo? Yung best friend mo. May something kayo? Gusto mo? Did you come? Yes. Pag nagkita tayo sa school, sa hallways, kuya mo pa rin ako ah. Umaga! You see, she didn't even remember everything that happened. Everything came in flashes when she was racking her brain, trying to remember what happened, trying to piece everything together, feeling guilt, shame, blaming herself for what happened. Was it her fault? Did she do anything to make him do that to her? What was she wearing? Why didn't she fight? Where are her bruises? These are the questions running through her mind. As she ensured, these are the questions that would be asked by the authorities. Do people do this for the fucking power dynamic? To feel superior over someone who is dead drunk, mentally and physically incapable of giving consent? Rape. Unlawful sexual activity against the will of the victim through force or the threat of force, or with an individual incapable of giving legal consent because of minor status, mental illness, intoxication, unconsciousness, or deception. Intoxication. That girl was deadbeat drunk. That guy was most certainly not. Something that did happen to me though was when I went out to hang out with my friends. Pumunta kami sa bar para uminom. At dahil may curfew ako, dun ako natutulog sa apartment ng kaibigan ko kapag pumaparty. Pero sa gabing to, wala yung kaibigan ko kasi out of town siya. But she still permitted me to stay there. My cousin, I had so much fun with my cousin and her friends, but nung umuwi kami sa apartment, dun ako natulog sa kwarto ng kaibigan ko. Habang yung pinsan ko at mga kaibigan niya, dun nag-chill sa kabilang kwarto. Dahil dito na ako, nagbihis na ako ng pantulog at ready nang mag-dive sa kama to be bound to dreamland. Kaso may katok sa pinto. Tok, tok, tok. wala akong charger. Pwede bang magpa-alarm na lang ako sa phone mo, tapos tabi na lang tayo matulog? Inisip ko, teka, wala sa usapan to ah. Wala sa planong dito pala to matutulog tong lalaking to.
Ah, malayo ba tinitirhan mo?
Oo eh.
Mag-a-alarm na lang ako dito, tapos isingin na lang kita dun sa kabilang kwarto. Puntahan na lang kita bukas, okay?
Ano, dun na lang ako sa internet cafe sa baba. Eh, baka kasi di talaga ako magising eh.
Ah, sige.
Di ba talaga pwedeng katabi na lang tayo matulog? Natakot kasi talaga ako na di ako magising para sa trabaho bukas eh.
Boohoo! Problema mo na yan. Huwag mo na ako isama.
Handa na sana akong matulog sa napaka-komportableng kama. Tapos magpapaiwan ka dito wala sa plano. Tapos may trabaho ka pala kinabukasan. Huwag ako.
But the past me didn't know any better. There was a time when I wanted to believe and see the good in people and to be uncynical, you know? Kaya nung nasabi niya yun, poor past Ella believed at naawa ko sa kanya. Kaya naisip ko, ganito na lang. Ako na lang yung mag-transfer sa kabilang kwarto kasi double deck dun eh. Eh dito, single bed lang, mas masikip pa. Mag-alarm na lang ako sa baba kasi ikaw sa taas para marinig mo yung alarm.
Sige.
Uncynical Ella proceeds to the other room.
Dito ako sa baba. Dito na lang din kaya ako.
No, dyan ka lang sa taas, ipa-full volume ko yung alarm.
Sige.
Sure ka bang ayaw mo talagang tumabi na lang ako sa'yo?
No.
Sure ako. Tapos afternoon, okay na sana. Komportable na ako sa kumo, tapos may aircon, tapos malapit na sana akong makatulog. Kaso,
Ella, di ba talaga pwedeng magkatabi na lang tayo matulog?
Hindi.
Bakit?
Taki na kailangan ko ba ng dahilan? Hindi mo pwedeng no is no, respect my boundaries.
Kaso, hindi yun yung nasabi ko eh.
I was too scared to cause conflict kasi paano ko magalit siya? Baka ano pang gawin niya o anong sabihin niya tungkol sa akin kapag nagtaray ako.
She's a bitch. Slut shame just for being there. Just like how many guys react that way when rejected.
Kaya ang nasabi ko na lang,
magagalit boyfriend ko. Sige lang, hindi ko talaga...
No!
Hindi talaga...
No! Singin nga lang kita bukas.
Sige.
Hey people! Nabilang niyo ba ilang beses niya akong pinush at ilang beses akong tumangke?
Hindi ko na nga rin mabilang eh.
And it freaking sucks how in situations like this, kailangan ko pang magsabing may boyfriend ako bago ako pakinggan. It's like, you need another male to respect in order to back off. Like,
oh, this is another man's property. I guess I'm gonna back off.
Like, hello, I'm a living, breathing human being of my own. I have my own thoughts, opinions, feelings. And you just listen when another man is involved? And in this case, hindi pa siya tumigil. WTF. You might be like, Ella, nothing happened. He didn't physically force you to have sex.
Are you fucking kidding me?
That happened in 2018. In 2021, nakita ko siya sa Instagram story ng isang kaibigan. And even though years have passed, I got triggered. Na-trigger ako kasi he doesn't even know that what he did to me was wrong. And the fact that he's freely going around town without the knowledge that it fucked me up. Fucks me up. I mean, if he got away with it, who knows what he'll do to the next girl? Bakit ganito sila? I remember this folklore about a celestial being with wings, a fairy woman who bathes in a lake in the forest and then goes back to the sky. One night, there was a man who fell in love and took her wings so she couldn't go back home and he could have her. Now, I think we know what the wings were a metaphor for, or at least what it means to me, but Fairy was miserable and wanted to go back home. One day, she found her wings buried under the soil and got to return back home. Ikaw may thinking, if he loves her, he wouldn't cut off her wings. Possession is different from love. In fact, it may be the opposite of it. And throughout my life, I've had my wings cut off many, many times.
Down to earth to take a dip into the largest lake in the forest. There was a man. He saw the fairy's wings she placed on a rock before she stepped into the water. Then he stole them. She couldn't go anywhere without her wings. So why would he trap her in his arms like she's just a thing? I'm not a toy you could play with. I'm not a hand-me-down from my father. Claim it. Don't need you to kiss my feet or be my slave. I just want to feel safe even when it's late. Don't want to live in a doll's house behind the yellow late. Don't wanna live in the girl's house behind the yellow wallpaper. Don't they understand? No means no is no is no means no. I hope you know. You should know.
I started cutting in high school. In Filipino, las las. How and why it started, I honestly don't know. I guess the problems piled up and I started hating myself. I think naglas las ako kasi it feels like a physical manifestation of the pain makes sense. But I'd rather transfer the emotional pain into something tangible. And instead of focusing on the problem and the emotion, I shifted my focus to the wounds. I'd also tend to it after. I like making myself think that I'm taking care of myself in some way, even though I know that's bullshit. When my mom found out, nagalit lang siya. She scolded me and she didn't even ask if I needed help. Sabi niya, naanagaan kita? Nag-effort pa kaming hindi ka kagatin ang namok, tapos yan ang gagawin sa sarili mo? Don't recall saying anything after that. I guess she just assumed that it was just a phase, just like my bisexuality. Pero hindi. Hindi siya tumigil. Lalo lang siyang lumala. Anxiety, hyperventilation, panic attacks. Minsan, umiyak ako araw-araw kahit habang nagkaklase. Hindi ko makontrol yung sarili ko. Kaya pumupunta ako sa CR para umiyak. Minsan, pumupunta din ako sa CR para matulog. Wala kaming tulog. No, may mga tao namang gusto akong tulungan. Merong protocol na kapag may nanghingi ng tulong para sa mental health, pupuntahin sa isang libreng programa kung saan maaaring magkaroon ng one-to-one sessions kasama ang isang eksperto sa mental health. Pero 1 month waitlist? Isang buwan? Okay lang sana kung pwede kong i-postpone yung mental breakdowns ko, ano? Uy, teka lang! Saka ka lang lumabas after 1 month. Sinubukan ko pa rin namang mag-register. Pero pagkatapos ng mga 2 buwang paghihintay, akala ko okay na ako. Kaya, hindi ko na tinuloy. I could have asked for help from a psychiatrist outside school, but I didn't want to be a burden. At alam kong mahal yung bayad ng therapy. So, I held out as long as I could. This is a song from the perspective of a boyfriend.
To wear when the world's just too cold to bear. But she gave everything, drained out all that's inside, and she cried on the floor feeling empty. Stayed in the shadows and she'd tear her own skin, and she won't let me know where she's been. Walking on eggshells around you, tread sun, but the world's so grim and dark, so ghastly, I'd clawed myself out to keep afloat. I thought you'd shed me some light, but I slipped away and now I'm gone. I stare at the flicker of the candle burning slowly in the dark. The side was a picture of you with a smile on your face that I barely see me, but all I see is you. Ellie got under my skin with her strawberry hair flowing in the wind. She gave me a flannel jacket to wear, but the world's just too cold for her to bear, but she gave everything, drained out all that's inside, and she died.
I thought to myself, this should be rock bottom, right? And I was just like, you know what? I'm so tired of feeling negative. I'm so tired of being sad. I'm so tired of being tired that I was just like, I'm gonna turn my life around, be a better person, take care of myself. In 2020, I started all these things, journaling, meditation, eating healthy, being on mental health apps. Minsan, tinitignan ko yung sarili ko sa salamin at sinasabing, ikaw ang pinakamaganda, strong, most talented na nilalang na nakilala ko. You are amazing. Then in March 2020, the funniest thing happened. Umuwi ako sa Cagayan de Oro at nung una, syempre masaya. I finally get a break. Pero isang gabi, we were on the rooftop eating dinner. My friend sent me the latest draft of the song I wrote. I played it on my phone. Akala ko nakikinig din yung mga magulang ko. Kaso, nung natapos yung kanta, I looked up and they didn't listen to a thing. In my experience with my theater friends, they were always so attentive and passionate about music and art. So to witness my family not caring about it made me upset. No. When I was downstairs, my mother started yelling at me. Apparently, nagalit siya na nag-walk out daw ako. Kahit na sinabi ko naman sa kanilang bababa na ako. Sa makakaklase nga anak. I don't wanna talk about it. I rushed to my room and she followed me. Sinubukan kong ilock yung pinto, pero tinulak niya already shouting, wala kang batas nga anak! Bastos! I don't wanna talk about it tonight while I'm upset. I tried to close the door, but my mother forced it open. Pagkasan nga, anak! Bastos! 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 They didn't stop yelling at me even when I couldn't breathe. I practically begged them to stop, but they didn't stop. Please leave me alone! I was panicking like someone was about to kill me. Pakiulura ka! Buwang ka! Everywhere I went, they followed me. So I went out the front door and into the night. Tears streaming down my face. Kapambahay lang ako nun. Panic. Tinawagan ko yung kaibigan kong nurse and she tried to talk me through it. I tried to calm myself down, sabi niya. Hindi ka po pwedeng makalabas kasi delikado pa dahil sa COVID.
pumunta ako sa playground. Tumupo sa swing. Ang ganda-ganda ng mga bituin. Ang lawak ng sanlibutan. Ang liit-liit ko. I think it took hours. Maybe 3. The night was cold, but I still didn't want to go back home. I couldn't. I didn't feel safe. At around 11, I had no choice but to go back to the house. Dad opened the gate. Wala ka na nang hindi na magawas. You think I had a choice? That's all you care about when you've seen that your own fucking daughter couldn't even breathe? Tomorrow na, please. Umakyat ako sa hagdan. Pasok sa kwarto. Tumiga sa kama. God, I feel so trapped here. You made me think it was a petty reason to have a panic attack, if you're like them. But that wasn't the only time. I grew up without my father, and we barely know each other, so I grew up with my mom. And it was the kind of home where it was normal to scream and hit your daughter until she was hyperventilating, and even then, they wouldn't stop screaming. Hindi nila naiintindihan na sa tuwing nangyayari yun, para bang nagsushort circuit yung utak mo, and you panic as if you're running for your life. Panic attack. A sudden episode of intense fear that triggers severe physical reactions when there is no real danger or apparent cause. When panic attacks occur, you might think you're losing control, having a heart attack, or even dying. May mga research na yung adrenaline o yung fight or flight response to danger ay involved sa mga panic attacks. Your heart rates and breathing speeds up as your body prepares for a life-threatening situation. The next day, I couldn't eat breakfast and lunch till my mom came in and said sorry, and then immediately proceeds to guilt trip me, saying something along the lines of, "Di ba nga ako okay nung nagsinungaling kang wala kang boyfriend?" Which was years ago. But that's not what this is about right now, Mom. I told them I didn't want to talk to anybody but a professional, a psychiatrist, because I knew that anything they said would trigger me. On the third day, I was alone on the roof deck when my father came in and started lecturing me about how life is short. Just pray to God. So we should just forgive and forget. Be happy. Just smile, oh. So you see why I didn't want to talk to anybody but a professional, right? If someone's got cancer, nobody will come up to them and say, "Hey, just exercise, eat healthy, you'll be okay. Just pray the cancer away." But with mental health issues, everyone becomes a therapist. So I said, I don't want to talk. It's not helping me. I went to the shower to take a bath, a ritual I find so important in my life. Something private I could call mine. Ella! But my dad followed me and wouldn't stop yelling at me through the door. "You are my daughter. You listen to me. I have the right to talk to you as a father." Trigger. And my mom came, joined my father, screaming, "You are so disappointing, Ella." Trigger. And I couldn't hear what they were trying to say because the panic was rising up again in my stomach, in my throat, in my lungs. "Please stop! Leave me alone! Please stop! They didn't stop! Leave me alone! 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 Leave me alone!" I grabbed my razor. "Leave me alone! Leave 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 me so I sat there, naked, blood dripping from my arm, waited until they came for me. Years I've kept it in, because my mother scolded me when she saw my cuts. Because the church said, belittle yourself. Don't think about yourself and give it all up to God. Because I didn't want to be a burden to others. Because I was scared. It took me years to finally speak up about it, and all I got from my dad was, you don't need to go to therapy to do the right thing. But how can I do the right thing when everything hurts? When every part of my body feels numb. When getting up in the morning is the most I can accomplish that day. I know my own daughter is not crazy. As if there's only one brand of crazy. Like it's either you're crazy or you're not. And anything in between, anything other is invalid. I know my own daughter. Do you? Really? Hindi nga alam ng tatay yung allergies ko eh. Tinanong pa niya ako recently, ah, di ba allergic ka sa isda? Daddy, mahigit na 20 taon na. Hindi pa naman nagbago yung allergies ko. Shrimps pa rin. Sabi niya, alam na daw niya lahat tungkol sa mental health. May kapatid daw siyang ganyan, kaya alam niya kung paano mag-handle. But in reality, he was doing the opposite. He told me I was weak, that I was wrong. That it was my fault that this was happening to me. This was the worst things you could ever tell a person with depression. At isa pa, this is called gaslighting. A systematic effort to make you question your own version of events. It can make you apologize for things that aren't your fault. You may be encouraged to think that you're actually to blame for something or that you're just being too sensitive. This is one of the different types of verbal abuse. I tried to tell this to them, over and over again, but they didn't listen. Nagulahan din ako kasi, when I have panic attacks, sinasabi na lang, okay lang daw ako, baliw daw ako. Pero nung nanghingi na ako ng tulong, sinabi nila, hindi naman daw ako baliw, at hindi ko raw kailangan ng tulong. It's all in your head. It took a long time for me to recover. Especially with scenes like these that are happening in my family and in my head. My mom and I reconciled because she was more flexible with change and open for education, but I didn't want to speak or do anything with my dad because of the trigger. He flew to another country for his job. I've never, ever felt so relieved. Hi, my loving Dr. Ella. How are you nowadays? I hope everything is going well with you. I just want to say, I'm sorry for all the things that I've done that hurt you and offended you. May God give you more blessings and happiness in life. I miss you. Love, Daddy. Hello. I'm finally having psych consultation after years of keeping to myself, being told I don't need help because mental health problems are taboo. Simply doing the right thing, or knowing that life is short, or to just smile, be strong, isn't the answer. If it were that easy for me, I would have done it a long time ago. Thank you for asking. Good afternoon, Doc. Para sa project na ito, in-interview ko yung pamilya ko. Lola, paano kayo pinalaki ng mga magulang niyo? Ano yung mga memories niyo nung bata pa kayo? Naalala ko, sobrang hands-on ng nanay namin. Maalaga, maaruga. Tinuruan kami ng mga gawain bahay. Pamamalengke, ganun. Yung tatay namin, hi! Kaka-stricto! Isang sabi lang, dapat sundin na. Kung hindi, ganito. Tapos, pinapaluhod kami sa yung bigas. Tapos,
ito pag hindi namin ginawa ito ng maayos? Taktik oras at lalukon. Mental health? Emotional? Wala. Wala kaming subject na ganyan. Hindi rin namin masyadong napag-usapan yung mga ganyan. Hi, Auntie. Paano nyo i-describe yung childhood nyo? Strict ba yung parents nyo? Naalala po. May isang beses si Papa. Hindi ko na nga maalala kung sino yung pinagalitan. Pero alam yung Belle? Pinaluan!
Mental illness is the third most common disability in the Philippines. 150
64 million Filipinos suffer from depression, 1 million from schizophrenia, and 15.3 million suffer from substance use disorders, while 877,000 die due to suicide every year. The stigma that mental health issues don't exist, that it's something to be ashamed of, should be eradicated. It's not bigger than what it really is, because it is big. And we have to do something about it.
Wala namang masama sa pagpapaganda. Yung iba, pinagtatawanan yung mga babaeng nagbabago ng hairstyle kapag heartbroken. Yung natural. Pagkatapos mo naman ang napaka-stressful at toxic na relationship kung saan napabayaan mo na yung sarili mo. Yung buong pagkatao mo, binigay mo na sa kanya. Tapos maghihiwalay lang din naman pala kayo. Hindi mo ba maiisipang magpagupi? Alam nyo, it's a way that a woman can feel like she can have a fresh start. A different perspective. A new chapter in her life. And men easily make fun of it like it's wrong for a woman to make change and have some sort of control over her own body, some autonomy over her own life. Basta, there's nothing wrong with femininity and cliches. You know, men have this urge, this desire to feel like they're the reason for all our decisions. There was this guy who cheated on me, and when I found out, hindi ako makatulog noon, mga tatlong araw siguro after I broke up with him. But at that time, I've always wanted to cut my hair short kasi I've always had long hair. So I said to myself, kung makakapasa ako sa UP, magpapagupit ako. And I did! Nagpapiksikat ako! Kaso, kinwento ng isang kaibigan ko that he told her that I cut my hair for him. I mean, for other exes, sure, I won't deny cutting my hair post-breakup, but for him, he was an exception. It was a celebration of my achievement, my hard work and awesomeness, and he took that from me and twisted the narrative to fit his egotistic, misogynistic, big dick energy and toxic masculinity. I'm like, who the fuck gave you the idea that I cut my hair for you? Literally nobody. Well, sadly, I didn't do it for you, honey. No, bitch, I do this for myself. And I'm perfectly capable of making my own decisions without the influence of a boy. Whatever success or choice a woman makes, men just squeeze into that, thinking they're a huge part of the woman's life. Well, I don't do my makeup for you. I don't cut my hair for you. And I certainly won't just smile and perform for your pleasure. I do this for myself. And maybe for the girl and the gays a little.
I cut my own hair today. I'd say shame you left anyway. We were in our hometown that night. Nothing else has ever felt so right. And so excruciatingly wrong at the same time. And if you somehow find your way back here, just know that probably be stupid enough to go right back from the start. Right from the start. Reminiscing the taste of that strawberry milkshake that we had on our dates. Never mind the heartbreak. Heartbreak engulfed in Christmas cheer. I look around, all friends are here, but it took one look, your green eyes made it so clear. Hailed a taxi cab to your house. I'll risk it all, no turning back now. Felt any other love as profound. Now you somehow found your way back here. You know that, dear, I've always been stupid enough to go right back from the start. Right from the start. Kindling the taste of that strawberry milkshake that we had on our dates. Never mind the heartbreak. The heart. Keep my bag, the one with the American flag. Gosh, we always miss each other and it's making me sad. And if you somehow find your way back here, just know that, dear, I'd probably be stupid enough to go right back from the start. Right from the start. Reminiscing the taste of that strawberry milkshake that we had on our dates. Never mind the heartbreak. The heartbreak.
With all the shit that I went through, ganito na ako ngayon. Strong, independent, healthy woman. And there are tutorials on YouTube on how to be that girl. That girl who takes care of herself, exercises daily, eats greens, meditates. For breakfast, I drink this green smoothie. The ingredients are 1 cup of spinach, 1 banana, 1 teaspoon of chia seeds, 1 tablespoon of oats, 1 cup of milk, and instant coffee. And here. Stay healthy, you guys. Ingat! Ala, kumain ka na ng rice, oh. Sunny side up, paborito mo. No thanks, counting my calories. Anong timbang mo? Huwag ka na kasi kumain ng maraming carbs. Mabuti pa kumain ka ng gulay at saka prutas. Taba mo na, oh. Magkakasakit ka niyan. Ako nga! Hala, underweight ka na.
I don't care.
Ano I don't care?
Ella, ang payat mo na, oh.
Can you not talk about my weight? Alam nyo, I'm trying to be healthy. I was terrible. I had fat phobia kasi palagi akong sinasabihan na, Chubby, uy fat, psst, tago mo yan. Bakit ba? Gusto niyo mga babae, payat. Like, you want us to take as little space as possible. To be poised, quiet, demure. Habang mga lalaki, ang laki-laki ng kinukuha ang espasyo. Yung iba naman, kumain ka nga, payat mo na. Ano ba talaga? I could never be enough for you. Mataba, payat. Bakit niyo sa katawan ko? Pwede bang enjoy ko na lang yung buhay ko in good health and balance? I realized that what I've been doing to myself and others was wrong. Listing everything I was putting in my mouth? Minsan, bumubuti naman yung pakiramdam ko. Pero minsan,
meditations every day. I'm so convinced that I don't care what other people say. My mind's bombarded with these hacks on productivity, how to eat, how to sleep, cause I love me. I think my affirmations aren't working on me today. Anxiety's off the roof, no I'm not well and sturdy. I'm working out, my best friend died, now I'm feeling lonely. My brain's a mess, it's like we're going on a panic party. Sorry for me, it makes me feel uncomfortable, cause I don't think it's worthy of your attention. But look at this art I made, it's pretty. I think my affirmations aren't working on me today. Anxiety's off the roof, no I'm not well and sturdy. I'm working out, my best friend died, now I'm feeling lonely. My brain's a mess, it's like we're going on a panic party. Panic party. panic party, panic party. Oh, my head is spinning round and round and round and round and round.
Higit pa sa sapat ang iyong pagsisikap.
kabaitan sa mundo'y ating ipalaganap. Sa kabila ng lahat ng kadilim ang naranasan, malalampasan din ang mga paghihirap. Ako'y matapang, dakila, makapangyarihan. Ako'y masagana, puno-puno ng pag-asa. Ay karapatan akong tratuhin ng mabuti. Pagmamahal sa sarili ay mahalaga, ako'y mahalaga. Ako'y mahalaga, ako'y mahalaga, ah.